Are we online? Yes, we are live. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to our weekly meeting. And tonight we have such a juicy, amazing topic. There is a lot of expectation about female sexuality and sacredness of the yoni. In Tantra, we call yoni the vagina, our beautiful flower, and is a way to refer to the vagina in a very sacred way. Yoni means also temple, your sacred temple. Yoni means the gate to the universe. Such important energetical area for the body of a woman. This area of the genitals of the vagina can be your main source of energy and vitality and creativity and juiciness of life, passion and enthusiasm of life, or can be a big shadow, big dark place which takes your energy down and block the energy of your entire being, right? In fact, so many women has a bad relationship with their yoni, with their vagina. So many women, obviously, we come from thousands of years of sexual repression of feminine energy. And even if we are modern woman, even if we have the lucky to born in this side of the world where we are a free woman, we choose what we want to be, what we want to do, we choose our partner, we choose finally, we are free to choose with who we want to make love and how we want to make love. But still, there is thousands of years of repression of feminine sexual energy, which somehow we hereditate from our mama and grandmama and all the women coming before us. Sometimes it's very subtle, so it goes, we hereditate through the education in a very subtle way, below, like below the world, you know, like really an energetical level. So much connected we are from the genital area, from the vagina and the womb and the pelvic area, with our mama, with our grandmama, with our female lineage. And most of the time it is our duty of as modern woman to heal all the lineage. I did this myself. I did a big journey into my sexuality. I remember when I was a young girl, I was not happy at all of my pleasure. I was not happy at all of the sensitivity of my yoni. And I was really like feeling not worthy, feeling like not, I couldn't compare myself to the other woman. I feel it was really, not feeling good with my body. I remember when I was a young girl, I used to go and call, I called my mama one time crying, "Mama, what happened? My vagina is not so sensitive. I should, and feel a lot, and it's not like that." And my mama, she told me, "Don't worry, you are like me. You have only the pleasure in the clito. You shouldn't look for nothing else." Well, mama, many years after, a few years after, I came back to her and I told her that I did a big journey with my body, with my vagina, and my pleasure completely open and unleashed. And she was so happy. She was so happy to know that I did this journey with my body. Because she said to me, "You did it also for me." So there is a big, big energetical connection at the level of the vagina with our lineage, female lineage. And sometimes it's our honor and duty to do this journey and to open and to unleash and to, to open to all this beautiful energy that we can liberate. Also for the woman who came before us that they didn't have the opportunity. So yes, we hereditate a lot, and sometimes it happens that women hereditate a lot of repression of sexual energy and many, many women write to me that they don't feel comfortable with their own body, that they don't feel comfortable with their own vagina. There is woman who doesn't like the smell of their vagina. There is woman who doesn't like the color. Now there is an obsession to have the vagina on a white color. There is even a surgery operation to make your vagina more white. That's crazy, you know? Or the shape of the vagina. Many women are, they feel shame about the shape of their own vagina. There is so much, things that we get from society that push the woman to at the point that she don't feel comfortable with her own body, with her own vagina. So many, it's very common. But if you are one of these women, what I really, really want to tell you from my heart is that the situation can change a lot. You don't need to stay like that all the life. There is many things you can do to recuperate the harmony and the relation and the love for your vagina as it is, because woman, we represent the variety in the universe. Each one of us is unique. We are all woman, we are all beautiful, and we are all unique. The blonde one, the dark one, the tall one, the short one, the thin one, the round one. And it's the same for the vagina. Each one of us have a different shape of the vagina. It's so magic. It's like the flowers in the nature. You don't see two flowers with the absolutely identical shape, right? Well, you don't find two vagina with identical shape. Each one of us have his own personality, and in the same way have his own, even the vagina have his own personality. Someone of us has a big labia, someone small labia, someone is more open, someone is more deep, someone is more dark color, someone is more light color. Even the smell can be big different, and all are beautiful. That's the magic of the universe, which manifests through the woman body, the variety of this manifestation, right? And so if you are one of these women which you don't feel comfortable with the shape of your vagina, with the smell of your vagina, you consider your vagina ugly, I really suggest you to do something, because something can be done. You can reprogram your brain at the point that you start loving your body as it is. You can do this with every part of the body. Yeah, you can start appreciate and love your body as it is, with your boobs, is there small, is there big, with your belly, with your buttock and everything. And you can do the same with your vagina, reprogramming your brain to love your body as it is, and eliminate all the models that we get imposed from society. Yeah, the perfect body, the perfect vagina, yeah, which is, it exists only in the television sometimes, not even real. So, a very simple ritual, which I wanna teach you tonight, is the ritual of the mirror. If you think you wanna work on the relation with your vagina, with your yoni, so this is the exercise for you. Every day, take 15 minutes, 20 minutes to be naked in front of the mirror. Take your time, light a candle, put some music, relax, get naked, and go in front of the mirror and sit in front of the mirror and open your leg. Yeah, open your legs and look at the mirror, your yoni. Yeah. Look the shape, look the pubic bone, look the outer labia, look the inner labia, and then you can open a little bit and look at the entrance and really send love and send your, connect your love, your heart with the vagina. Yeah, do this every day. You will see that in the long term you will change this attitude of not liking your body as it is, because it's not like the model in the television. Yeah, so take some time to become sister with your vagina, become twin sister, become, she has to be your best friend, because this is where your maximum feminine energy come from, you know, your source of feminine energy is so, so powerful if you reconnect. So reconnection, you know, again, due to thousands of years of sexual repression, due to strong education, due to sexual trauma, or even every time you made love and you didn't feel enough comfortable, or you, the man was not present and conscious anymore, or you was not ready, you was not connect yet your body with your heart, this can create a tremendous disconnection between your heart and your mind and your vagina. Out of this, what happened is there is many women who they have the vagina not enough sensitive, numbness of the vagina, insensitivity of the vagina. The vagina is not sensitive. There is the pleasure outside, in the clito, it's okay, but with the penetration, in the deeper part of the vagina, not so much, it's numb. There is so many women. This obvious prevent you to go for a deep vaginal orgasm, which in Tantra it is considered a very beneficial experience, not only for the pleasure but also for the energy. Yeah, we already say many times, if you see all my video, my article, that the deeper part of the vagina can liberate a huge quantity of energy, which is very beneficial, like compared to the clito. The orgasm from the clito is okay for starting the love making or because you're alone and it's easy to find. But the energy that unleashed from the clito is explosive. It's like the ejaculation, the orgasm with the ejaculation for men. So it's not an orgasm which recharge of energy, which can really dissolve tension, calm down the mind, open the heart. This is belong to the deep vaginal orgasm, which, yeah, it can be the from the G-spot or even deeper from the cervix. So this is an invitation again to explore the deeper part of the vagina. And again, many women, when they explore the deeper part of the vagina alone, with a self-massage or with a partner or with the penetration, they say that they don't feel enough. There is no sensitivity, there is this numbness. And this is because there is this dissociation, there is no connection between the mind and the genitals, because we, the subconscious mind, associate the genital with shame, with fear, with feeling not worthy and don't like yourself and so on, don't love yourself and so on. So the mind, what to do? Like, I don't feel, I close everything, I become insensitive. Yes, there is many women in this condition, and I receive many male and many women in our workshop that they ask for advice. Well, again, I want to let you know that there is many things you can do if this is the condition. If you are one of these 80% of the women who are unable for now to reach the vaginal orgasm, the deep orgasm, what you have to know is that this is just a condition that is like this now. It doesn't have to be like that forever. There is many things you can do in Tantra. And this journey can also be quite fast, I tell you, for a direct experience. Yoni massage is for sure one of the main tools we have. Normally when a woman approach Tantra, most of the times they approach Tantra because they're unhappy of their sexual life. They want to do something to open more. And the yoni massage is one of the first things that normally women do to unleash, because it's really one of the fastest way to open. I just shoot a series of video in Italian and in English. They are in our Facebook page about the general yoni massage. Yeah, the first video, then the second video, it was about the G-spot massage, and this coming week I will shoot a video about the cervix massage. So this is already a little course that you can do, and you can learn by yourself, because as a woman you can stimulate all the spot inside the vagina alone, even if you don't have a partner. And if you have a partner, then even better, you can ask him to help you. Yeah. So massage all the spot of the vagina to create again this connection between the mind and the deeper point of the vagina. I will not spend so much time tonight talking about that because I tell you there is a series of video you can go and watch, even in YouTube. One is already in YouTube, in our channel. And but yes, yoni massage is really one of the main tools that normally women use to open sexually. Yes, and can be really fast. Sometimes from the first massage, if you have a professional massage, you know how to unleash the energy, especially from the G-spot. But even if you're not so expert, doing the mapping, do your own massage, like constantly, every couple of days, or even better, every day, you will see that this numbness of the vagina goes away, and instead a strong sensitivity of the wall of the vagina, like the vagina waking up, the sleeping beauty waking up finally, and then when you make love, you will really feel a big, big difference. So yoni massage is also a beautiful tool if in case of sexual trauma. I know a woman who live in the condition of hypertonia, means too much tension in the genital area, too much tension in the vagina. There is woman who live with the vagina very contracted. The muscle of the vagina has to be strong because sometimes we need to contract, but has to have also this quality of softness. We need to be able to surrender, to open when there is the right condition, when there is sacred intimacy, when we feel safe, when we feel protected, when we feel loved, right? If we are not able to open even when there is the right condition, and I tell you, there is women who live with the vagina super contract, they cannot open, they cannot even put a finger inside. In the more serious case, it is also a disease, which is called vaginismus, or spastic pelvic floor. There is woman who can stay sit in the office or in the house because there is contraction in the vagina and they feel pain. Normally behind these conditions there is always serious sexual trauma, so the reason is always psychologically. So normally it is suggested for this woman to ask help for a professional psychology, somebody who can help, support, psychological support. But yoni massage can be a beautiful help, yeah, your own self yoni massage. So if you are one of these women who feel the vagina too much contract, so take time every day, you warm your coconut oil, you create a beautiful atmosphere, and you massage without the expectation of reaching orgasm or feeling pleasure. You know, it's really a massage, like when you have your tension, shoulder tense, you want to receive a massage. Well, in the vagina is the same. You can go for a professional massager, but you can also massage yourself with some warm oil, coconut oil or almond oil, okay? Take some time to massage also the outer part. Don't force, you don't want to force and go in. You want to really massage very good all the outside, the labia, the pubic bone. Take some time from the entrance and slowly, try to make the muscle soft, okay? The idea is that even if you had a trauma and you feel the energy there is completely blocked and you cannot open, what you have to know is that you can do something. Don't stay like that. It would be very pity that you spend life like that, because there is so much energy that can be released in your genital area from your sexuality that can really become your main source of strength, source of vitality and power, female power and enthusiasm for life. Yeah, and normally it is possible to see when a woman is sexual blocked, when she carries some blockage at the level of sexuality. There is more tension, there is more, I don't know, a kind of shade, you know, some shadow the word. While you see women that they start with the tantric path, very soon they start to be like shiny again and feminine, and they don't need the lipstick or big makeup or fake boob to feel feminine, you know. It's a feminine power which comes from within. It's such a beautiful, and I did this journey with myself, so I can feel the big transformation in my self-confidence as a woman, and that's why I have this mission to go in life and support many women is possible. And in many years in Tantra school, I witnessed this, that many women, they come with this, kind of frustration, and after 2 months, they are like, super shiny. So the energy of your sexuality influences your life very deeply, very deeply. And that's why it's really worth it to take some time and do this journey with your body. Yes, this is another aspect I want to tell you. So, yes, these are the two main conditions I want to talk about. The condition of numbness, so the disconnection between the mind and the vagina. So the mind somehow refuses to feel the vagina. And like this, the sexual energy cannot be free, cannot somehow explode in terms of energy. And the other condition is when the vagina is too contract and too tense, again there is always some traumatic experience behind that, and you can do something, you can really do something with the massage. Yes, that's one I wanna say. Okay, sister, I see many sisters. Ciao Kimena, ciao Saraswati. I'm ready for your question if you have. Okay, if there is no question, let's see. I can talk about another topic. Yes. Okay, let's talk about the strength of the pelvic floor. The pelvic floor, woman, we give a lot of attention to the muscle of all the body. We take care if the buttock is hard, the abdominal muscles are strong and so on, the legs have to be strong, but very often we don't pay attention about the muscle of the vagina, the pelvic floor, the perineum. These muscles are very, very important, not only for the sexual pleasure, but for the health of the woman. The pelvic floor is a series of muscles which are somehow interconnect with each other, and they have together the shape of a hammock. This hammock is connect in the front from the pelvic, the pubic bone, and in the sacrum in the back. Okay, so we have this series of muscles like an hammock, which is down there and sustain all the weight of the organs in the abdomen. Okay, in the lower abdomen we have the womb, we have the urinary bladder, we have part of the intestine, so much blood vessel and so on. All this create a lot of weight in your abdomen, and all this weight is lying on the pelvic floor. The pelvic floor is a muscle, muscular, is made of muscle, and has the duty to sustain all this weight. Yeah. In the pelvic floor, we have different holes. One is the anus and one is the vagina, right? Obviously, having the hole of the vagina, our pelvic floor is a little bit more delicate of the pelvic floor of the man. Also for men is very important, but for women is more important because we are more delicate down there, and then we have the womb and we have to give birth. So the vagina has to be able to enlarge to allow the baby to born, and obviously this muscles is a very important muscle, and it has to have two characteristics at the same time. It has to be strong, resistant, because again it has to sustain all the weight of the abdomen, but in the same way it has to be elastic and soft, because you want to be able to open and surrender, and you want to be able to open when you make love, also when you give birth, right? So strong muscle but soft, and and tender. Yeah, it's a very peculiar condition. It's an important. It has an important work to do. This pelvic floor, which is should be our best friend for woman. Yeah. For sure, is very connected with sexuality. Because again, the orgasm is nothing else than a series of contraction and relaxation of the pelvic floor. So more the pelvic floor is strong, and more the contraction are strong, and more the experience of orgasm is fulfilled and deep and powerful, and more energy can be released. Yeah. In the other way, again, it has to be soft, because if we contract, and very often we contract because woman stay contract because they are not able to surrender too open, because there is some fear behind, obvious, and so it's also not so good. So what do women do regularly in Tantra? We train our pelvic floor. How we train the pelvic floor? With contraction, which is called Kegel. Kegel exercise. It's very easy. You contract the muscle of the vagina and you relax. You contract the muscle of the vagina and you relax. Yeah, you do your body work of the vagina, the kung fu of the vagina. Yeah, you can start gradually doing 30, 40 contraction, and then slowly, slowly you can increase. This is very good because first of everything, this contraction and relaxation, it somehow, when you contract, the old blood flows away, and when you relax, some new fresh blood comes in. So it's very, very useful for women, because the blood circulation in the area of the vagina gets renewed, also in the utero, in the vagina, the channel of the vagina, the wall of the vagina. So you know that when the blood flows properly, all the toxins are eliminated, new oxygen are coming. So the level of the cells is very, very healthy, preventing all the disease of the wall of the vagina and the utero. Yeah. So it's very, very healthy. And also at the level of the energy, we somehow renew or refresh the energy. And again, we create this connection between the mind and the vagina. So that's amazing, amazing exercise that you can do anytime. You can do it when you drive, when you wash your dishes, when you sit in your computer, you know, nobody will know. It's your secret exercise. Contract and relax. Contract and relax the vagina. That's very, very good exercise. Yes, so I give you three exercises already tonight. The first one, the mirror, the exercise of the mirror to change your connection and relationship with your vagina and start to like your body as it is. And then the yoni massage, I give you a little introduction, but again, if you want to know more, you can go in the webpage to see the videos. And now the Kegel exercise. This is normally what tantric women do in the beginning to increase the energy at the level of the genitals, because we say that if it's true that sexual energy for women is a tremendous source of energy and vitality, but we want to awaken this energy. We want to remove any kind of trauma. We want to remove any kind of taboo and repression. Otherwise, the energy cannot flow. Yeah. And this is what tantric women do in the beginning to unleash this powerful energy and to revitalize, to energize the area of the vagina. Okay. This is what I want to say for tonight. Let's see if there is some question. Somebody asking me, how can I tell to my boyfriend how to give me pleasure? Oh, this is a very, very important, very, very important question. In fact, many, many women are afraid to ask to her partner something which she likes, you know, like, again, we come from a culture where until 50 years ago, even less, a woman has no right to ask for pleasure. Yeah? Only men. Pleasure, sexual pleasure was something that was belonging to men. The woman was not allowed to have the right to be orgasmic and be sexual and feel pleasure. Well, darling, I tell you, to feel pleasure, orgasm is your birthright. Yeah, is your birthright. You have all the right to open to this beautiful energy. So, first of everything, we need to get away of all the shame and be open to talk. How many couples really talk about sexuality? Maybe in the conscious couple, but not in the normal world where people are not conscious, not so much. They don't talk, yeah? And this can create a frustration that can stay there for years and slowly can damage the couples from the bottom, from the basement. So be free to open, to talk about, be open to talk about, don't be ashamed to ask, yeah? Even if you feel your energy is blocked and you feel you need to do something, share this with your partner. It's a beautiful journey to do together, I tell you, because I did this with my man. And in fact, now we are together a long, long time, but this unites us very, very much. There is someone of you watching there that they know us since a long, long time. And they assist to this big transformation that we did within the couple. To share this journey with your partner is a beautiful journey. So don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed if you are a man that you feel you need to work on your sexuality. Don't be ashamed to share with your girlfriend. And if you are a woman, don't be ashamed to share with your man. To share that you want to unleash, you want to open completely. Maybe you are not yet completely open and orgasmic. Well, you can do this together, and this can unite very much the couple, instead to be something which separates you, instead to be a challenge for the couple, become a challenge that you wanna overcome together. So it can really become a beautiful way to connect. So don't be ashamed to ask to your partner what you need in bed, yeah? Don't be ashamed to ask him to go more slowly. Normally men run too much, you know? Don't be ashamed to ask that you need more time for warm-up. Or don't be ashamed if you want a stronger lovemaking. Don't be ashamed to ask him to touch in one spot in another spot. What happens most of the time is that women don't know where to touch their body to find this orgasmic feeling, to find this pleasure. This is one of the big topics. So again, we go back to the topic of the yoni massage. First of everything, to be able to ask to your man what you would like, you need to know. So you need to know your body. That's why this is really an invitation to explore your body deeply, to do your own tantric massage, to discover every spot of the vagina, what you like, what gives you still some tension and you want to release. And so you need to know your body, okay? You need to know where to find your pleasure. Only after this, you can ask to your man, yeah? And again, get away of all the shame and don't be afraid to ask. Yes, thank you for the question. Somebody write, women pleasure is a man pleasure. Oh yes, that's the number one topic for tantric men. Yes, I agreed. Let's see, there is another question. Okay, no other question. So again, if you want to know about more, if you want to know more about tantric massage, go to to this Facebook page before on YouTube. You can find one part of the massage, and then if you like, you write me and I will send you an email with the previous part of the massage. And next week, they can, because we will talk about the cervix. You know what is the cervix? Woman knows, but maybe not man. You know when you make love with a woman and you penetrate her deeply, very, very deep, there is a very special point which makes you very crazy, because there is a very strong energy. I used to say there is a diamond there. Go and pick the diamond there in the deep part of my body. Yeah, so this is the cervix. The cervix is the beginning of the utero, okay? So there is the vagina wall and then the uterus. This is the beginning of the utero, when the lingam penetrates the yoni. At one point, with the tip of your lingam, with the tip of your penis, you touch the bottom there, and this can become a really, really extremely sensitive and erogenous area. This area, I just give you a little introduction of what you will learn in the next video, the cervix massage. This area is supposed to, in Tantra, is a very precious area, because for woman is the more yin receptive feminine energy in all the energy apparatus of a woman. And guess which is the more yang masculine part of the body for the man? Yes, the tip of the lingam, the tip of the penis. So when a man penetrates a woman deeply, the tip of the penis, the tip of the lingam touch the cervix, then you have the perfect match between masculine and feminine, the perfect match between yin and yang. And we know that at the level of the universe, the maximum potential of energy is liberated when yin and yang, masculine and feminine, meet. Yeah? So potentially when this happens between the tip of the lingam and the cervix, you are creating the maximum universal energy, the maximum potential of energy. When the cervix is liberated and activated, the woman can experiment the deepest and the more powerful orgasm. It is said the real tantric orgasm. This kind of orgasm, which comes from the deeper part of your body, it goes straight away to the highest chakra. It creates a tremendous sublimation of energy toward the highest chakra, to the Anahata chakra, the heart, but also to Vishuddha, the throat chakra, the third eye, so even better, Sahasrara, the crown chakra. So there is a very strong flash of energy to the upper chakra. And this is very, very beneficial. It's what we want to do in yoga and meditation, in all the energetical practice. So again, we have two choices. Or you spend hour and hour in the yoga mat, or you spend hour and hour making love, and you send all this beautiful energy up through your cervix orgasm. Again, very, very often for women, many women, instead to feel pleasure in this point, you penetrate there deeply and they get contract. They feel, no, don't touch that, I feel pain. Because there is tension, because there is dissociation again, because there is numbness, because there is contraction, there is no opening, no surrendering. So again, it's a matter of massaging the cervix. Massaging the cervix, this is what I will teach you in the next video. To give yourself a massage, you have to have your own tools, your magic stick, and massage the deeper part of the vagina. And if you are a man, and there is a few men, look at me in this moment, if you want to open a woman sexually very deep in the cervix, and this, I tell you, is the best present you can give to a woman, she will love you forever. So you can teach her to relax the abdomen, massage her in the lower abdomen before, obviously, you reach the cervix really late in the lovemaking, okay? So it's the last step, because the cervix open for is the last one to open when all the rest is surrendering. So give her a beautiful, beautiful massage. Take time to warm her body. Take time to massage all the other part of the vagina, and then you go deep there. And if she feel pain, you keep go there very soft, and you invite her to breathe. And relax, and breathe, and relax. And through breathing, through relaxation, through surrendering, this part of the body, the deeper part of the vagina, instead of being painful, start to become super energized, super amazing. The sensation is amazing, and slowly, 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 it rise, and it can open to a deep, beautiful, deep tantric orgasm, and you, guy, can follow, can ride this tiger. You can orgasm together with her without ejaculation, without exploding, like interiorize your orgasm exactly with that. Yeah, this is about the cervic massage, which is the cervic orgasm, which is the purest, the highest, the strongest tantric orgasm. But if you want to know more, Tuesday I will post invitation and inspiring video about the cervic massage and how to open a woman at this level. Yes. So let's see if there is more question. Otherwise, I let you go. I see a lot of things. I'm sure you have many things to process, especially if you are a woman. If I say something which touch you and you are entering in a process, your own process, I'm very happy. And don't forget that I'm here for you. So if you need support, I'm always here for you. You write me, I'm here for you anytime. Okay, sister? We can do this journey together. Yeah? Okay. Yes. No many questions. So for now, I let you go. Ciao.